All right, this is the best that the junkyard can pick up for us.
Let's sit up there and see if it fits.
This is definitely a better hood.
Here, I got it.
You got it?
Which way are we going?
Here, then that needs to go up. We'll fix that.
That was well executed.
All right, fingers crossed.
Yeah, if this doesn't fit, we're screwed.
So our latest odyssey started with a simple quest. Find a truck that we could build for the coolest truck show in Texas, the Lone Star Throwdown.
Anyone who builds trucks, drives trucks, or loves trucks is gonna be there. And since that pretty much includes everyone in the garage, we thought it was finally time for Gas Monkey to join the party.
Texas farm truck right there.
We found a sweet 49 Chevy sitting in the field.
It hasn't been messed with at all.
We'll take 2,000 for it.
That's a good deal.
And we were so smitten.
Yeah, that's
cool.
We decided why not go for broke and turn it into a show quality truck.
That bar is set really high.
Y'all on board?
Yeah,
absolutely.
I mean, we wanted to go to the truck show just for fun, not to compete, but we're Gas Monkeys, so there's no way we're gonna show up without something a little extra special of our own.
Killer.
Y'all get it off and get started.
Oh!
Only problem is we had 6 weeks to do it, and most people can't turn out a show quality truck in 6 months.
What? Your chassis work's done.
Yeah, right.
To make that happen on such a short timetable, my goal was to completely pre-build the truck in 2.5 weeks before we took it apart and shipped it to paint. But as luck would have it,
hey, this right here is wonderful.
We had more sheet metal repair work than we anticipated.
This is not gonna work.
And we had a lot of fitment issues that slowed us down a lot.
This hood officially sucks.
This one's no different.
As a result, we're almost a week behind schedule, and that's a week we didn't have. So everyone's feeling the pressure.
And here's the topper. I've got a guy interested in buying the truck, and I want it to show well to help seal the deal. So if we don't make the show, well, he might not be interested in the truck at all. And if that happens, well, our love affair with trucks might be over.
Watch that motor mount over there.
Okay.
You're good right there.
Whole frame flies off the jacks.
Right on my foot.
So we've arrived at the next critical juncture in our 49 build. We got our chassis back from powder coat last night. Now it's time to begin the assembly for real, for real.
We want to get everything we have available right now onto the frame, get all of our plumbing, obviously the motor, transmission, exhaust. Probably a 3-day project at least.
We're days behind schedule, but this is where all the work we did pre-building the truck should pay off.
Ready to set this cab? Risky business right here.
Yeah, I got you. Go for it.
Yeah,
got one coming up on the right leg.
Germs, you all right, brother?
What do you need?
Come on down, Jason. You're so high, we can't tell anymore.
Okay.
And you need to come forward about 1.5 inches. Right there, stop.
You got the alignment rod in here for the front. Pins in it.
Well, that's great, then. This side's 100% then.
You want this?
Ooh, buddy, it's tight on there, ain't it? It's tighter than I even thought it was.
Well, there you go. The cab is sitting back on the chassis, and it's fitting pretty well. But there's no time to rest on our laurels.
I think our best bet.
We need to get the rest of the front end assembled and then get our ignition and our fuse box wired so we can fire the engine. Or this Chevy's not going anywhere.
I've been fighting these windows for like 3.5 hours.
Should be simple, should go in easy. It's what the instructions say. Oh wait, there are no instructions for this.
I think what it really is I'm just tired.
Here we are, last day of the build. Still got a million little things to do. We've still got a full bed that has to be assembled with all the wood planks. It's a big job. To be honest, the pressure is getting more intense as the day goes on.
Incredible, guys. Where do we want to go? Hey, let's lay the blankets out, yeah.
We're all pretty tired. I've got the truck, for the most part, wired up. Everything's getting down to that point where you have time to do this, you have time to do that, you have time to do that. If anything gets disrupted in any manner, we ain't gonna make it.
Got fire hydrant.
Whoa, turn it off.
There's steering fluid everywhere.
Hey, Jeremy, why don't you go ahead and clear down there?
Huh?
Why don't you clear down there?
I don't know what happened. We're just trying to heat cycle it.
Hey, start the motor, please.
Don't get your hands.
Turn it. No, go ahead, start it, and I want to see it.
Whoa.
God dang, I'm gonna throw my arm off.
Yeah.
That's power steering fluid that's spraying. We blew the rack up.
Yeah, let's just soak up the mess and wait for the exhaust to cool down.
Here, okay.
I've let it cool off. Let's not go any further with that.
This is exactly the kind of thing that could stop us dead in the water.
Don't panic yet.
Still be something simple. But still be something simple. Don't give up.
So we're just trying to run a heat cycle on the engine. Part of the break-in process where we let the motor run for a few minutes to get up to temperature and let all the fluids expand. And, well, Charles went to turn the steering wheel and the power steering just blew up.
As soon as I just touched it, it went like that. It moved my arm straight like that.
Normally you hook up your stuff and you put your fluid in and yay. Blowing fluid everywhere like that, shaking the steering wheel violently, that's not a common problem. That doesn't usually ever happen.
Germs, keep a smile, keep a smile. Deep breaths, deep breaths. Need y'all to get out of the way.
Aaron, what you got there?
Diagram for the power steering rack. I want to check something out.
Yep, I think I found the culprit.
What are you thinking?
It's the pressure line.
So, on these right here, the same rack runs two different ones depending on years.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
So the pump for our power steering system has a high pressure line that sends fluid to the rack and a low pressure line that returns it back. It turns out that the lines from the pump that we installed are plumbed two different ways depending on the year the rack was made.
Pressure line, top one. But in this year, pressure, bottom one. They look identical. You just have to know how they made it. Oh, geez.
Unfortunately, we got the line switched.
Oh, we'll get this thing on.
So when Charles turned the steering wheel, it sent high pressure fluid the wrong direction and blew out the seals on the servo.
So it blew out.
Which means the steering rack and pinion needs to be replaced.
Lay it over on the ground. John's going to fetch one right now. We have to verify the one we're getting is the same one.
Okay.
I've already got someone racing to the parts store to see if we can rustle up a replacement rack before closing time. Now we just need a little luck. We've got so much left to do on this truck, it's like planes stacking up on a runway.
Still beating it, so let's just keep moving. Keep pushing forward.
Last piece. Last chance for romance.
We've had 1,000 things that I didn't anticipate on this one. And I should have, but I didn't. And I wouldn't say they got the better of us, but hasn't been a cakewalk.
Gentlemen.
Oh, every time.
What a
guys, a lot of hard work. Definitely a lot of late nights.
Yeah.
Absolutely killed it. One hell of a job, guys.
Thank you, sir.
I'm glad everybody made it down.
Yeah,
I had a good time riding down, too. So we just barely finished our 1949 Chevy 3100 last night, somewhere around midnight, 1. The pressure was definitely on the last 2 weeks of this build, and everybody absolutely pulled their weight and then some. But we're here. It's time to relax, check out some of the cars, maybe have some beers and a turkey leg.
All right, let's go.
Look at that truck.
Okay, we're trying.
Thank you all very much for supporting LST 2016. For making this happen.
You want to watch a couple of the awards before we meet up with the rest of the guys?
Sure.
All right, let's light this candle. We're going to start with the Best Debut Award, and that goes to the Black 49 Chevy pickup to the good folks at Gas Monkey. Richard and Aaron, come on up and get your award.
Golly, man. Maybe I should have dressed up for the occasion.
Right on.
So we weren't really counting on this, but the guys that put on the show decided to give us an award anyways. Best debut. I'll take that honor. You know, it is our first time to show this truck, and to see my guys get some official recognition for all their hard work, well, that's bonus.
You know, thank you guys all for coming out. This is a great event, and usually this is where I grandstand a little bit, give you some woos, but these guys busted their ass, so I'm gonna give the mic to Aaron. Aaron?
One thing I wanted to do is bring what's left of my crew. These gentlemen here worked around the clock, and thank you for coming by and checking the truck out and just taking the time to take a look at what we put so much effort into. Thank you very much.